A 2013 study found that, unusually, the more an operator used this highly specialized robot, the less effective they became at carrying out their job objectively. What is this robot used for? I'll read it one more time. A 2013 study found that, unusually, the more an operator used this highly specialized robot, the less effective they became at carrying out their job objectively. What is the robot used for?
Objectively, I think might be one of the key words here.
My first thought was that it was a sport thing, that it was something like Hawkeye in cricket or like the or tennis, like the line judge thing, that the more the operator starts to rely on it, the less they actually start to be able to make the call about whether the ball's in or out. But also, I went for the cricket reference first. Sorry, folks. Caitlin is not immediately nodding at me, so I suspect I'm wrong.
She has a good poker face. I wouldn't put it past. You could have gotten it spot on, and she's just playing it cool.
I want you each to have a chance to chime in a little bit before I give too much. I want to see where this goes.
Yeah, I was thinking sort of like AI, ChatGPT style robot, but 2013 study makes me think that that's probably not it. Can we ask if it is it sports related?
It's not sports related. And Evan is correct in focusing on that word objectively.
It also said robot and not like sensor system or something like that. Like the Hawkeye system is not a robot. It'd be cooler if it was, but it's not. It's cameras and algorithms.
Is it a physical robot?
It is a physical robot.
Ooh.
So it's interesting because it's a physical robot doing something where there's an objective outcome, not a technical outcome. So it's not assembling. It's not like, you know, doing anything where it's technically correct or wrong. It's objective. And that's the thing that like really...
Let me just clarify, because there's a lot of like they's in my question. The less effective the operator becomes at carrying out their job.
Yeah.
Effectively.
So the operator of the robot becomes less and less objective as they use this robot.
Yes.
Oh, now I'm just stuck on like giant mecha Gundam suit from anime. just big old exoskeleton but that's still not a robot.
This is a job that there's a clear advantage to doing it with a robot.
Okay. Is it a remote operated vehicle or is the person operating it locally?
It is remote.
Ooh.
So what jobs need robots?
Like agriculture, uses drones, but objective. I'm wondering, does it have to do with like grading applicants for something and... but a physical robot to grade.
And university admissions at MIT are now actually just graded by a giant robot reaching in and just sweeping people into one bin or another.
I will say the reason that the doing their job objectively becomes an issue is not because they lose the skill. The operator doesn't necessarily lose the skill to do that job. It's not like they become reliant on the robot.
Oh.
I've been hanging on to this. I don't, it's kind of a dark thing, but I think, you know, UAVs and you know, military people operating.
If our producers have put a question about drone strikes in this episode, I'll be stunned.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think that anyone's going there, you know, because there's some like ethical concerns there and everything. But I'm just going to kind of set that aside and move on, because that's where I kind of went, because you can be so removed.
Yeah. Well, there's also if you get too much information about something, like if you are like military related, but also like UFO related. If you have like too many image sensors around a base and you get too much data on objects that are moving, you're going to get like animals and cars and like things that are just not relevant. And if you have a robot helping you with that, getting more UFO data makes you maybe less objective at like identifying what's relevant. But again, that's like sensors, not a robot.
I will say that you're not totally off base with the warfare.
Oh, really? Wow.
Whoa. Okay.
All right. This is going to be a very difficult question to tread a line on from now on. Okay.
Yes.
To help you guys out, it's kind of wholesome.
Wholesome.
I know.
Wholesome.
It's
wholesome and warfare. That's really interesting.
I'm throwing you a weird combo here.
What jobs use robots and fit all those criteria?
So it is remotely operated and it's a physical robot. It has to do with war and it's wholesome.
Or like bomb disposal? Because like bomb disposal robots are a thing.
It could be a bomb disposal.
But I don't know how you would objectively...
Wait!
Oh.
I think I might have it based on like an article I read a long time ago. People who operate bomb disposal robots form an emotional connection with their bomb disposal robots.
What?
Yes, because they like their robots. They form a bond with them and they feel saddened when the robot dies. So they may take maybe less risks because they don't want the robot to blow up when they're disposing the bomb.
You got it.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. So yeah, the answer is bomb defusal. And it's basically exactly what you said. A study found that operators like anthropomorphize their robots. They give them names. Often the names will be like their girlfriend's name or like a pet name. Like they treat them like a person. And they build an attachment to them. And over time, they start to get wary about putting them into harm's way.
Oh.
So, yeah, there's a study. They interviewed 23 explosive ordnance personnel, and the soldiers admitted they felt frustration, anger, even sadness if a field robot was destroyed.
Wow. That's interesting.
Yeah.
I remember reading the phrase somewhere, and I cannot think of the source for this, which is humans will pair bond with anything. Like you give a thing a name and a couple of eyes and humans will just go, yep, I love that now.
Yeah, well, if you can zoom in on our feed right here, guess what our microphones have?
Oh, yeah, they have eyes and faces. Yeah, we tend to do that. The majority of our, especially our large tools, all have googly eyes and they get names. Yep. So like, I so related to this story.
I can't believe you randomly read an article that is useful at this moment in your life right now. That was perfect timing.
I just really like robots. And technically, when one of our projects, we needed a mobile remote operated base.
We're building a car for our cat.
We were building a remote operated car for our cat so we could drive
it
around.
As one does.
And guess what I found online for a reasonable price? The base of a bomb disposal robot.
Oh, wow.
So we do.
What happened to the rest of the robot? Actually, never mind. I know what happened to the rest of the robot.
We just used the base. We just used the base.
Yeah. Yeah. It was a stock base.
Wow.
So bomb defusal robot operators develop an emotional attachment to their robots and it causes them to perform their job less objectively.
Wow.
It's crazy.